Now, the woman who wants to remain anonymous told me that she and her husband are struggling financially, and they had to recently move out of their home and into a motel. Other folks, well, they're unemployed. Tamara Davidson said she lost her job due to health concerns from COVID-19. She told me she's at high risk, and her doctor said that she shouldn't go back to work. She and others are struggling to make it through this.
I'm starving. I haven't ate in 2 days. You know, because usually we have, you know, kitchens that we can go to, but you can't go to them no more right now.
She's unemployed, and I'm only down to 20 hours. So,
trying to make it.
For months, we heard from Speaker Nancy Pelosi that she wasn't interested in a big COVID relief bill, $2.2 trillion. Or she was only interested in a big COVID relief bill. She wasn't interested in a more narrowly tailored, smaller bill that could possibly get passed. She told you why for months, October, November. She told you why she was standing in the way of a relief bill.
Can you look them in the eye, Madam Speaker, and explain why you don't want to accept the president's latest stimulus offer?
Well, because, thank you very much. Wolf, and I hope you'll ask the same question of the Republicans about why they don't really want to meet the needs of the American people.
It's a scene playing out across the country. Jam-packed food banks like this one in Arlington, Texas, which provided Thanksgiving meals for 5,000 families. Lee Cowan spoke to hungry families in San Antonio for Sunday morning, including Catherine Nguyen, a mother of five who lost her job as a housekeeper during the pandemic.
You have to, like, decide if you're going to pay a bill or not, or decide to go get groceries, and maybe your water or your lights might get turned off the next month or something.
It's not easy. I lost my job. I had, like, 4 months with no income.
But let me say to those people, because all of my colleagues, we represent these people. I have for over 30 years represented my constituents.
It's just a mess out here.
Where is the poorest, dirtiest, most depressing slum in the world? In Haiti? India? Africa? Is that what this is?
No, I'm in America. This is San Francisco today.
Hey, bitch, stick that camera up your ass.
Some people shoot up in plain sight.
It's nasty.
I have for over 30 years represented my constituents.
It's nasty.
I know what their needs are. I listen. So when you say to me, why don't you accept theirs, why don't they accept ours?
Meanwhile, it is Democrats who passed a comprehensive coronavirus package way back in May, and they passed it again in October. It's currently languishing somewhere in Mitch McConnell's office next to the John Lewis Voting Rights Act.
Yet this bill goes out of its way to supply illegal immigrants, who, in case you needed to be reminded, have no right to be here in the first place, with billions in taxpayer dollars. According to House Democrats, illegal immigrants must have a right to have the $1,200 checks that American citizens received in the last bill. They would also receive the same direct payments as American citizens going forward. So, in effect, it's a huge payoff, the Democratic Party's most cherished constituency, a group that's not even allowed to be here. And then it goes on from there. The bill contains an amnesty provision. For the duration of the coronavirus crisis, that's something I'd like to see extended a very long time, all illegal immigrants employed in so-called essential services would be shielded from deportation. And their employers would be shielded, too. People who hire illegal aliens could not be prosecuted.
Second. Let me just quote Ro Khanna, a man you know well. I assume you admire him. He's a Democrat. And he just said this. He said, people in need can't wait until February. $1.8 trillion is significant and more than twice the Obama stimulus. Make a deal. Put the ball in McConnell court. So what do you say to Ro Khanna?
What I say to you is, I don't know why you're always an apologist, and many of your colleagues, apologists for the Republican position. Ro Khanna, that's nice. That isn't what we're going to do, and nobody's waiting till February. I want this very much now, because people need help now.
What has shifted now when they're on board with this piece that's come out of the Senate?
Perhaps you missed what I said earlier. Joe Biden committed to ending and crushing the virus.
Protecting Americans' health also means fighting infectious diseases. We are coordinating with the Chinese government and working closely together on the coronavirus outbreak in China. My administration will take all necessary steps to safeguard our citizens from this threat.
That is a total game changer. A new president and a vaccine. It's for a shorter period of time, but that's okay now because we have a new president. A president who recognizes that we need to depend on science to stop the virus. That isn't what we're going to do, and nobody's waiting till February. I want this very much now.
Schumer and Pelosi wanted $2.2 trillion. Now you're looking at a compromise deal of about half of the White House offered, $908 billion. We don't even know if we're going to be able to see that passed. Looking back, was it a mistake for Pelosi and Schumer to turn down $1.8 trillion?
There was some exuberance involved because an election was coming.
There was some exuberance involved because an election was coming.
But to return to those pre-election days and sentiments, political sentiments, is very difficult.
The fact is that when it comes to relief for the American people, Nancy Pelosi is absolutely right to not capitulate to the White House the second they put forward whatever excuse they can cook up and then call it a relief bill.
After months of saying and giving various reasons why a bill wouldn't be passed, she's now coming clean, essentially, in her own words. Well, it's because now we have a new president. She's more willing to look at doing a deal.
Yeah. And the reason is that the Republican Party is clearly not operating in good faith. Trump and Republicans already refused to pass a relief bill last week and only reversed their position when they got bad press as a result of it.
It's so predictable, it's almost boring. You know, it wasn't a mistake, it was a decision. Of course, just being honest, they made a decision to say it could have benefited President Trump at the time. People are suffering. We could have done a smaller bill. Republicans repeatedly came to the table saying, PPP, these are different opportunities. We're willing to do it. She held out till after the election. Now it's okay, because she might have the person she prefers in the White House.
And beyond that, when stimulus talks stalled, there was a sell-off in the market. And if you know anything about Donald Trump, it's that while he couldn't care less about the American people, he will bend over backwards for the market. So
it's about the children. Let me just say this just yesterday. You know, everything I do is about the children. That's the reason I am, you know, having five children, my own nine grandchildren. I worry about everybody's children in America, of course.
House and Senate Republicans aren't happy. They say House Speaker Nancy Pelosi tried to smuggle pro-abortion funding into the original bill.
It's about the children.
Well, Tracy, Republican lawmakers I spoke with say that the actions of House Speaker Nancy Pelosi are, quote, repulsive. They say that Speaker Pelosi tried to lobby for several provisions, including up to $1 billion to reimburse abortion labs.
And I worry about everybody's children in America.
It's political. It's, you know, it's really quite disgusting, quite frankly.
An Hispanic child is 8 times more likely to be hospitalized with the virus than other children.
Speaker Pelosi and the leadership of the Democrat Party are trying to take advantage of a crisis like coronavirus.
People are dying.
Yeah, there's people dying, there's people getting sick, and we need to be serious about this. This is above politics.
In reality, if Trump wanted to give the American people relief, he would have encouraged Mitch McConnell to do it at any point over the literal months that the Democrats' Heroes Act has been languishing on McConnell's desk.
It's currently languishing somewhere in Mitch McConnell's office.
Languishing on McConnell's desk.
And then there's the long section in this legislation about drugs. The bill is strongly in favor of drugs, probably because when you're high, you're less likely to think or worry about what else is in the bill. The bill mentions cannabis 68 times. It orders the federal government to produce an annual report on, quote, expanding access to financial services for minority-owned and women-owned cannabis-related legitimate businesses. Democrats would like to see more drug sales in minority neighborhoods. That's in this bill.
Let's be honest here. The only reason that Trump even wants this bill now is because he wants to send another check with his name on it. He wants a cheap victory.
Yeah, I mean, she's been despicable on this. And Pete, you are right on this, in that Republicans came to the table multiple times and said, let's do this and we'll talk about the rest later. Let's get the relief to individuals that need it. And she did not prioritize that. It looks like it's been highly political. And it's not the first time we've seen this from her. We just, you know, finished covering a few weeks ago the story about her going into the hair salon and having a separate set of rules for herself when it came to the masks, which left everyone wondering, well, how does she actually feel about masks? Is that a political talking point as well? So she has been exposed on many counts, this being just the latest one.